we had a school send something into near space. I mean, when a teacher looks over all the kids in the school and they say, do you want to go to space? I mean, the reaction is amazing. And so what we have now is the fruits of weeks upon weeks of students preparing to send these experiments into near space to test near space conditions.
We came up with ideas, and the second grade class and our class voted on it. In total, there were probably around 20 items, and then we only sent up 5 of them, so we narrowed it down by voting.
Today's payload went up. They had a couple of different things. They sent up some slime that they wanted to see what would happen. Would it change its consistency at all? Would the exposures to the small amounts of radiation, as well as the extreme temperature changes, do anything to the composition of the slime that they made? They kept something slime back from the same batch that they made, so they have their control experiment back here with the one that they're sending up, and then they will run their comparisons and analysis when they get back. This is our second iteration of near space balloon launch gear. Funded by the Cherry Creek Schools Foundation, we were able to jumpstart our first set of launches, and that entailed a completely different set of equipment. And what's happened this year was that our school district has felt that it is such a valuable teaching tool. It's such a valuable, large-scale learning experience for kids that they've made it a line item, and we were able to refresh and get brand new gear that allows us now to track data real time, capture video, and transmit everything back to us as we speak right now. Thank you to our entire school district and for seeing the value in what large-scale learning experiences can do for kids and make the difference between going to school and propelling them to the next level. This beyond prepares kids for what they're about to take on next. So thank you, Cherry Creek.